There is nothing more comforting than first thing in the morning, waking up, it's freezing cold. You build a fire, put the kettle on, and that little sound of it percolating is just, I don't know, it's kind of like ASMR for me. Just lovely. Yeah, I just leave that out for them. I normally fold up that little bed thingy and put it away, but I left it there today. And Sonny, he just went ahead and curled up on it and is taking a little nap. What are you doing, boy? Hi, Papa. You guys have destroyed my floor again. Hey, everybody. Ann here, sitting inside the tiny house, having my coffee. It's like 30 degrees outside, but it's sunny, and it's going to be a beautiful day. I've been doing a few things, just kind of like boring things, but one thing I know for sure is I'm starting to get a little antsy with the appearance of certain areas of the homestead. So I need to just get it taken care of. It's not going to be done in a day, but I need to get rid of that huge stack of cardboard way out behind the shed. I need to start focusing on getting rid of the trash that was left here from the prior owners and some that I've contributed to as well. I'm just getting tired of looking at it, and it's not good to have that stuff just laying around. So, you know, there's Maslow's hierarchy of needs? Well, we're going to call it Anslow's hierarchy of needs. I've had my most basic needs met. So I'm gonna show you a little diagram and explain what I'm talking about. Here's a chart of Maslow's hierarchy, I can't say that very well, of needs on the path to self-actualization. You got to conquer the bottom needs before you can get all the way to the top. Bottom needs are physiological needs like food, water, warmth, rest. And after that, if you've conquered that, then you can work on your safety needs. And then after that, you can work on belonging and love, all that kind of stuff. And then after that, you can start working on esteem needs and then self-actualization. And you know what? I look at this and I kind of think, well, there's times when I conquer one level and I go up to the next one and then something happens. I have to go back down to the lower level until I can work all the way up. I haven't gotten to self-actualization yet, but I'm hoping that someday I will. I feel confident that I will. I put these two charts here to kind of compare. The one on the left is the official one. The one on the right is mine, kind of in my own words. So the bottom part, food, water, energy, and rest, I've conquered. Basically, I have conquered. And what I mean by energy, I mean my ability to cook, you know, find the energy to cook, not physical energy, but heat source. Or a source of energy to keep things cool. I've got the generator, so that's good. I burn wood to keep warm and to cook. And then rest. Most nights, I've been getting pretty good sleep. The next one in the green, shelter, security, self-sufficiency, freedom. That pretty much has been conquered. I do have shelter. I feel secure where I'm at. I'm becoming more self-sufficient, so I haven't quite passed this stage yet. Hello, Campy. And I do have freedom. I have the freedom to do what I want to do. The next level is psychological needs. And you know what? I don't have a lot of human interaction. I kind of like it that way. So I kind of feel that I achieve this through my dogs, my chickens, and through connecting with others like me. Miss Donna B and I have become very good friends. We just kind of click. Oh my goodness. We are like each other in so many different ways, but unlike each other enough to, you know, I learn a lot from this lady. So I love you, Donna. I love you. Anyhow, the next level is esteem needs. And I achieve those through doing projects, building, growing things, And all of those things kind of help me build my own self-esteem. So I'm kind of doing pretty good with that, but there's a lot more that I need to do and learn and know. And then finally on the top is self-actualization. I am not there yet. Nope. I'm a long ways away from that. I've got so much work I still need to do. On the blue level, I have a lot more to learn. I need to learn how to do the chainsaw thing, and that'll help build my self-esteem. Growing, I haven't got that quite nailed down yet, but once I do and I'm growing most of my own food, it's going to really elevate my self-esteem. So I'm looking forward to that. Psychological needs, yeah, I could have a little bit more human interaction, but, you know, my thing is I love being around my dogs, I love being around my chickens, and I love being around others like me. So, I mean, I've pretty much got that level nailed down. The green level, shelter, security, those are safety needs. I still have some work to do on that. I haven't finished the tiny house. Once that is done, I'm going to be able to sit back and just kind of excel in other areas. So yeah, this is Anslow's hierarchy of needs. And this is kind of how I'm approaching life. And you know what? This theory still holds true today for me. When I learned it back in psychology many, many moons ago, I didn't doubt at all that at one day I would achieve the top rung. I'm not quite there yet, but I'm looking forward to the day that I do. Look at my hair. Look at my curls. I can't believe that these days my hair is like naturally curly. Anyhow, yeah, so I have been achieving things, but I've got so much more to do and learn so that I can grow as a human and maybe extend, you know, myself to others more. But I've really got so much more work to do around this homestead. And like I said earlier, I'm getting into, you know, whereas before, at first, I was just wanting to secure shelter. You know, I was living and working out of my van. That was shelter. It worked out great. And now I'm here and I've been building up the inside of that tiny house. It's got a lot more work that needs to be done, but I'm going to get it done someday. And I know that once I do, it's going to be a huge sigh of relief. And so hopefully you guys have enjoyed coming along with me and experiencing my self-growth, you know, becoming a homesteader. I'm not really a homesteader yet. I mean, I got a few chickens. I grow a few things, and I've been able to preserve a few things. But I have got a long ways left to go before I really consider myself a real homesteader. But I've got plans. The future looks bright for me. It really does. And anytime that I'm feeling down or sad, I know all I have to remind myself is that I've achieved a lot and I've been able to accomplish a lot. You know, I'm going to get the trash removed someday. I'm going to get the, you know, the cardboard broken down and done something with eventually, hopefully sooner than later, because it's really starting to get on my nerves. But that's a good thing, because it didn't used to bother me, really. I mean, I knew it was there. I knew that, you know, it needed to be taken care of, but I was so busy taking care of other things that the aesthetics of my property really didn't bug me. But now that I've achieved certain things, it's starting to bother me, so I got to get on that. Anyhow, thanks for listening. That's all I got for you guys today. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you like, subscribe, hit the bell, and y'all have a good one.